بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور انفسنا وسيئات اعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له، واشهد ان محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى اله وصحبه اهتدى بهديه وسلم سنته الى يوم الدين. ثم اما بعد، as we started last week, the verses related to our siyam, and we said this is tawfiq from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that we covered these verses just before Ramadan, only a few weeks left, and we are approaching Sha'ban very soon, only a few weeks. As last year, I asked this question to some brothers. I asked, can you smell something? Now we are in the mosque. Can you smell something now? Yes?
Yes.
Yeah. Some brother they have. What do you smell now? Yes. Yaqub alayhi salam. He was the father of Yusuf alayhi salam. That's why when the Prophet asked, who is the most noble person on the earth? Then he asked, who is that? Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Yusuf alayhi salam. He is the most noble person. Why? Because he said, Al-Kareem, Ibn al-Kareem. He is a prophet, son of a prophet. Yusuf alayhi salam, Yusuf ibn Ya'qub, ibn Ishaq, ibn Ibrahim. So if you said, who are you? You know, in Bangladesh, you can't get married unless you are descended from a very noble family. I don't know this, I don't know which tribe you are from. Now, if you find someone, he is a prophet, and his father is a prophet, his grandfather is a prophet, his great grandfather is a prophet. Yusuf alayhi salam. His father missed him for many years, and you know the story. The point I would like to highlight here is what? At the end of the story, when his brothers, they get to know him, and he said, إِنَّكَ لَأَنْتَ Yusuf. Are you Yusuf? He said, yes, I am Yusuf. وَهَذَا أَخِي بِنْ يَمِينَ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed us. So he said, take my shirt to my father. His father, he became blind. Why? Because he was really grieving. He was really sad because he missed Yusuf alayhi salam. After they said even Benjamin, they kept him in Egypt because he's stolen something. Said La ilaha illallah, and he start to remember Yusuf. قالوا إنك تذكر يوسف حتى تكون حرا أو تكون من الهالكين. Still you remember Yusuf. Then even he asked them, go and look for Yusuf and his brother and don't give up, don't despair from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Again, I'd like to come back to the point is what? فَلَمَّا فَصَلَتِ الْعِيرِ Now the caravan, the camels left Egypt going back to Jerusalem. They took the shirt of Yusuf alayhi salam from Jerusalem, from Palestine, coming to Egypt. Look at the Quran said, فَلَمَّا فَصَلَتِ الْعِيرِ Just when the caravan, the camels left Palestine, Ya'qub alayhi salam, his father said, إِنِّي لَأَجِدُ رِيحَ يُوسُف I can smell Yusuf now. Ya Allah, look at the distance, how far it was. Because he missed Yusuf. He is looking forward to see Yusuf. So once his shirt just left Palestine, I can smell Yusuf. Ulama said, who is looking forward to be in Ramadan? Who can smell Ramadan now? Everybody said, oh yes, I'm missing Ramadan. When Ramadan will come? Believe me, when inshallah Ramadan coming, after Salat al-Asr, you will see different smell. Yes? No doubt. In Ramadan, there's different environment. Different, you will feel this is something different. The sense of Salah, the sense of Qiraat Quran, the sense of everything.
Even if tasty, سعري استيز دقر صحيح. Even رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said that تسحروا فإن في السحور بركة. Take سحري, because سحري is بركة, is blessed food, not like any food. Even the food in Ramadan is blessed. And shall we cover this very soon today? So this is, we are covering Ramadan, fasting. And there is few rules, few masail about our fasting, and we need to learn them. And subhanAllah, Imam al-Qurtubi, he mentioned all of them in points. And we need to go through these points one by one. Last time we talked about the fasting itself, the fard. And it was in the beginning, was optional. The fard was only 4 days, if you remember, 3 days from every month, and Ashura. Then Ramadan was prescribed to fast, but in the beginning was optional. If you want to fast, you can fast. If you want to pay fidya, you can. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَأَنْتَ صُومُ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ. But if you fast, it's better for you. Then Allah said, no, it was fard, only optional for those who are really suffering, who are really have the hardship to fast. Those people, yes, they have this option, but if the fast would be better, even if they are not traveling. Now, وَعَلَى الَّذِينَ يُطِيقُونَهُ فِدْيَةٌ طَعَامٌ مِسْكِينٌ. The people who they have hardship to fast, what they do? They can pay a fidya. Number one, who are they? Old person, ill person, traveler, pregnant, the mother, the foster mother. So these are the people who are, they have the hardship. So, I mean, they can fast with a sort of hardship. Ulama, they said, for the old person, khalas. You can't say he is like ill person or traveler who is going after Ramadan, he can make up whatever he missed from Ramadan. No, he's old person, khalas. So what the best for him, or the only way, is to pay the fidya. Some ulama said, there is no Ramadan on him because he can't. But majority of ulama, the jumhur ulama, they said, no, he will pay. Even Anas ibn Malik, he was old person, he's old man. The, you know, Anas, he was very old Sahabi. He, more than 100 years. What he did, he couldn't fast Ramadan. What he did, he make a big walima, and he invited 30 miskeen. Because every day you feed one miskeen. So he invited 30 of them, all of them they ate, and this is for Ramadan. The pregnant, some of them said she is like an ill person. She will wait until she can give the birth, then she can fast. But the problem is, she's going to again feed the baby. Again, she's going to be in a trouble. Then, data for her again to feed. Some of them said, no, she should fast and feed. Pay the fidya. Feed miskeen. How? Because normally last week we said, what if someone missed few days from Ramadan? After Ramadan, he should make up this fasting. What if he said, later, Sha'ban come, inshallah, just before Ramadan, oh, Ramadan has come, and he didn't fast. What he should do? After second Ramadan, he must fast those days, plus pay the fidya. Some of ulama said he should really straight away after Ramadan fast them. Some of ulama said he must really fast these days in order continuous. He shouldn't really give any gaps. And some ulama said no. As long as he fast the days before the next Ramadan is fine. But if the next Ramadan has come, then he should really fast and pay the fidya. I come for the most important point now. الفدية, how much is it? And they said, "Son, Lord, nowadays you don't have the dates, we don't have the wheat, we don't have, even if you give the maskeen wheat, what is going to do with the wheat?" You know, some, still up to now, some ulama, some madaif said, you have to give the food. But nowadays, madhab Abu Hanif said, you can pay the money, fidya money. Why? Because nowadays, if you get the money, you can buy the bread, you can buy the rice. Yes, if you give rice, it's alhamdulillah, it's good. Raisins is fine. You have dates, it's fine. So this is a food people they can eat, and this is enough for them as a meal. فَمَنْ تَطَعَ خَيْرًا فَوَ خَيْرًا وَأَنْ تَصُومُ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ If you fast, is much even better. Come to the next verse. أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان فمن شهد منكم الشهر فليصم ومن كان مريضا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخر يريد الله بكم اليسر ولا يريد بكم العسر ولتكملوا العدة ولتكبروا الله على ما هداكم ولعلكم تشكرون. The next verse, شهر رمضان. The month of Ramadan. علماء say, do we have to say شهر رمضان, month of Ramadan, or we can say Ramadan? Some of them said, no, Ramadan is a name of Allah. One name of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Ramadan. So don't say, I fast Ramadan. So I fast the month of Ramadan. But this is weak opinion. Why? Because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself, he mentioned, جاءكم Ramadan. Ramadan has come to you. He didn't mention شهر Ramadan. He didn't mention the month of Ramadan. He said, جاءكم Ramadan. Ramadan has come to you. The gates of Jannah is open. The gates of Jahannam is closed. The shayateen chained. So this is hadith, Muslim, Sahih Muslim. So now, yes, you can say Ramadan. And quickly, by the way, you can't name Allah with any name except that name should be in the Quran or in the Sahih Sunnah, in the authentic hadith. The names of Allah don't. This is very important because some people, they will look, say, oh, how beautiful this universe. Oh, Allah is the best designer. So, excuse me, who said designer is a name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? You can't say that. You can't say, oh, subhanallah, how beautiful this is, the best art, is the best. It is not, don't. The name of Allah must be in the Quran or in the Sunnah. Otherwise, you should not, we must not name Allah with any other name. وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى فَادْعُوهُ بِهَا Allah has the beautiful names. When you call Allah, call with the names of Allah which have been revealed. If any other name, don't. It's a part of aqidah. So we can't imagine or just invent any name. الَّذِي أُنزِلَ فِيهِ الْقُرْآنِ شَهْرُ رَمَضَانِ فرض الله صيام شهر رمضان. The شهر, when we say شهر, means we look from the moon sighting up to the moon sighting. From the beginning of Ramadan, after Sha'ban, I have to look at the moon sighting. When the شهر رمضان, the month of Ramadan is finished, when I look at the moon sighting of Shawwal. This is a شهر. If I want to fast, this is a very important point because there is a quite many opinions here. When you look at the moon sighting, in the time of Sahaba, the cities was really away from each other. Sahabi came from Sham and he met Ibn Abbas. Ibn Abbas asked him, when did you fast? He said, we fast on Friday. Because we, the night of Friday, Thursday evening, we saw the moon sign, the moon. So we fast. And Muawiyah, he was the Khalifa at that time, he commanded us to fast. He said, no, 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 we saw the moon the night, next night, night of Saturday. Right. Now there are opinions here. Number one, if one city saw the moon and they fast now 30 days, the people who saw the moon next day, they might fast only 29. Should they fast that day or not? Imam Abu Hanifa, he said, they should really fast that day. Because, he said, when تُكْمِلُ الْعِدَّةِ, you should really finish, complete the number of the month. And the month started before us one day. If we couldn't see the moon, but some other they saw the moon. So that means we missed that day. Because there was no enough any way, any means for communication. So we missed that day, we should really fast it. Ibn Abbas hasn't got this, no, he said no. Whatever, this is our month. And every city, they have their own. Imam Malik has the same opinion of Imam Abu Hanif. Imam Shafi'i, Imam Ahmad said no. This is our month. Their month, they will see. Our month, and the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, their opinion is what? Imam Abu Hanif said, لِتُكْمِلْ عِدَّةِ. We should really complete the month, and the month started before us. We couldn't see the moon. So we should really fast the day which we missed. Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, Imam Shafi'i said, no, but Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that صوموا لرؤيته وافطروا لرؤيته. Fast when you see the moon, and break your fasting when you see the moon of Shawwal at the end of Ramadan. So it is related to us. Ulama, they said, if the cities next to each other, then this rule will cover them. But if the cities at that time, there was Medina and there was Andalus, Andalusia, Spain. So to go, they need, even they said from Sham to Hijaz, need 1 month, sometimes few or 3 weeks at least. See, this, okay, you can, each city, they have their own moon sighting. Yeah, the problem is nowadays we have, the globe is one city, one village now. You can't find any. Once some people see the moon, خلاص, it will cover everyone. Here you come for the next. How many people should really see the moon, then you can fast? Is it enough for one? Or we must need two? Shahada usually is two. But here, in Ramadan, there is a hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in Medina, they tried to see the moon, they couldn't, so they slept. One shepherd, he was with his sheep in the desert. He came to Medina late night, 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock. Congratulations, people, Ramadan is tomorrow. He said, no, we haven't seen the moon. No, I have seen the moon. Oh. He went to the Prophet and said, Ya Rasulullah, I have seen the moon. Then Rasulullah, he commanded all people in Medina to fast because of one person. Imam Shafi'i, he said, it's better for me if someone said, yes, I have seen the moon, it's better for me as wara, as fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If someone said, tomorrow is Ramadan, it's better for me to fast that day rather than to, even if it was doubtful. Even if it is, but here I would like to clarify this. Even if he's one, he might make mistakes, but better for me to fast that day. Even if he made a mistake and it is Sha'ban, better for me to fast it. But when I said doubt, don't take it as Yawm al-Shak. Yawm al-Shak haram to fast it. What's Yawm al-Shak? People, they try to see the moon, no one has seen the moon. No one has seen the moon. No one has seen the moon. But someone said, okay, let me fast tomorrow. Although everyone decided tomorrow is 30th of Sha'ban. But someone said, let me fast that day in case I will fast it. If it is Ramadan, Alhamdulillah, if it is Sha'ban, that's no harm. No. You can't do this. Now we should, even Rasulullah he said that فَإِنْ غُمَّ عَلَيْكُمْ فَاقْدُرُوا لَهُ. If you can't see the moon, اقْدُرُوا لَهُ. The meaning here, ulama, they get it in different meaning. Ulama said, اقْدُرُوا لَهُ, estimate it. You have the calculation as we have nowadays. Some ulama, even Imam Malik has this opinion. Said you should, one of his opinions, Imam Malik, that all the time do the calculation. At that time. Ulama, about 50, no more than 80 years, big muhaddith. He made a research about this point. He said, people calculation nowadays is not like before. Because some of people, they have an excuse. The Prophet said, نحن أمة أمية. We are illiterate ummah. We don't know the hisab, the calculation. And at that time, people who have this calculation, the astronomer or what they call them at that time, they were using the stars for, you know, for the sihr, for fortunate, for, you know, it's haram. So the Muslims, they don't study this, they don't learn, because this ilm, this science, is haram science at that time. But now, there is a science for the planets, for the stars. Calculation is in seconds. When they say there is eclipse on that night, at that time it comes. And this is ilm, science. Allah al insan wa lam ya'lam subhanahu wa ta'ala. He taught subhanAllah the human being. If you take it in that sense, there is a science and there is a calculation, and nowadays they can say yes, how the moon, how the sun, how the earth moving at that time, on that night, at that dot, exactly this minute, the eclipse will start and the eclipse will finish after this time. And it happens. So calculation is very accurate now. Many of ulama nowadays say it's no harm to take the calculation. But because of Sharia, because of the Rasulullah said, صوموا لرؤيته. When you fast, fast when you see it, the moon sighting. Here they said, no, we have to see the moon. Ulama said, why can't we combine this together? You look, try to look for the moon and use the calculation as well. Yeah, so this is very important point. Now, and usually people when they come, it doesn't make sense. Some people, they have seen the moon, you can't say no, no, no. And the ikhtilaf for one or two is, it's not that really big. But to find some people say, no, everyone should see the moon, then tomorrow will fast, then you will miss one or 2 days, at least 2 days. No, no, no. This opinion is, I don't want to say it wrong, but is really, it's not really the correct one. Now, what Imam Shafi'i, there is one point here. What if one person, he saw the moon, and the other said, no, no, no. He hasn't seen the moon. This person himself, should he fast or not? The sunnah is, one is enough to see the moon of beginning of Ramadan. But finishing Ramadan, to say tomorrow's Eid, you need two, not one. Because to fast is much easier, but to break your fasting is no. We should really make sure that, yes, I can break my fasting. So two. This person who said tomorrow is Ramadan, and people said, no, tomorrow is not Ramadan. Look, the rule for himself, he must fast Ramadan.
Because himself he has seen the moon. People, they might have an excuse, but himself, no. He should fast. Even if he didn't tell people I'm fasting, but he must fast. And if someone clearly has seen the moon of Shawwal at the end of Ramadan, he must break his fasting. But he shouldn't tell people. This is again another point. طيب. Here Abu Hanifa has mentioned, if some people fasted 30 days and others fasted 29, they should really make up one day after Eid. Shafi'i said no, you didn't need, because every city they have their own moon sighting and they have different opinion. Imam Hanifa, his evidence is when you put al-iddah, you should really complete the month. And Imam Shafi'i said no. Rasulullah said, "Sum al-ru'ayati wa aftur al-ru'ayati." When you see the moon, you can fast. If you don't see the moon, you could really complete Sha'ban 30 days. Right. Now come to the very important point. الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it really clear. Ramadan, the month which Quran was revealed in that month. Ramadan itself was blessed because of the Quran. Quran was revealed in that month, on the night of Laylatul Qadr. Number one, Laylatul Qadr is only one night of Laylatul Qadr in Ramadan. We're coming very soon, I think in 2 weeks' time, people said, oh, Hameen, Inna Anzalnao, Hameen, Kitab al-Mubin, Inna Anzalnao fi Laylatul Mubarak, Inna Inna Mubin. فيها يفرق كل أمر حكيم أمر من عندنا إن كنا مرسلين سورة الدخان. When they said إن أنزلناه في ليلة مباركة, they thought, some people they thought that it is the midnight of Shaaban. It is not. Here Allah سبحانه وتعالى said إن أنزلناه في ليلة القدر. Quran was revealed from اللوح المحفوظ to the first heaven on Laylatul Qadr. Then from the first heaven, Jibreel take it bit by bit over 21 or 23 years.
Subhanallah.
طيب. Now, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. Quran was revealed in Ramadan. Even ulama said that, even Hadith, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, they said that all books was revealed in Ramadan. Suhuf Ibrahim was revealed in the first night of Ramadan, first day. Torah was revealed on the 6th of Ramadan. Injil was revealed on the day 13th of Ramadan. Quran was revealed on the day 24th of Ramadan. That's why many of ulama, they have opinion that the night of 25th is Laylat al-Qadr. There are many hadith about the 21st, 23rd, 25th, 27th, 29th. 25th, we have hadith here. Many hadith about the 25th of Ramadan. Quran was revealed after 24 days of Ramadan. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. So Ramadan itself was blessed because of the Quran. This ummah blessed with the Quran. Yourself, if you stick with the Quran, you will be blessed. Once you be away from the Quran, you will find your life miserable. This is even in Surah Taha. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, this Quran, once you be with the Quran, hold on the Quran, respect the Quran. When you say the respect, the Quran itself. Ulama, they said even Rasulullah said, he mentioned, because there's some opinion, he said, we have only one Quran. All copies of the Quran, we call it Mus'haf. We call it Mus'haf. Why? Because some people said, yeah, we have another Quran. Like Shia, they said, we have another Quran. This Quran, only one third of the Quran is in this Quran. The real Quran, Quran Fatima.
and she hide it because other Sahaba, whom the Sahaba, she had said this kuffar. Why? Because they took the Quran, they amend the Quran. They said, oh, this is Quran Fatima. This is Quran is Quran. إِنَّا نَحْنُ نَزَّلْنَا الذِّكْرَ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this Quran and Allah protect this Quran from anyone who touch a single letter. So Quran, that's why when we said we have mushafs, we have copies of the Quran, but the Ummah has only one Quran. But ulama said, too cool, some of the, some verses, or to call the Mus'haf, oh, this is Quran, it's no problem. Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned this. He said, then don't take your Quran to a kufr land. At that time it was dangerous. Because it was enemy land. If you take the Quran with you, they might mess around with the Quran, and they might really don't respect the Quran. They might. So he said, don't. Try to use the Quran which you memorize. If you take the Quran with you, you might get some, it might really, they don't respect the Quran. So you might. Quran was revealed in Ramadan. So if, وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكَ وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكَ وَنَحْشُرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْمَى Whoever turn away from the Quran, doesn't respect the Quran, doesn't recite the Quran, because Hajj the Quran is different ways. To desert the Quran, to be away from the Quran, is different way. Someone, he doesn't listen to the Quran. Some people say, why should I listen to the Quran? I want to recite. Even listening to the Quran, you must learn how to read, recite, memorize, listen. Use the Quran as a treatment, as a cureness. Shifa. وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ Shifa is a cure, but only for mu'min. Shifa in Quran was mentioned twice. One shifa for everyone. فِيهِ شِفَاء لِلنَّاسِ For all mankind. This cureness for all mankind is what? The honey. يخرج من بطونها شراب مختلف الألوان فيه شفاء للناس. سورة النحل about the honey come from the bees. This is فيه شفاء cures for everyone, all mankind, Muslim, kafir. Honey is cures for them. But for the Quran is another شفاء, another cures. But this one نزل من القرآن ما هو شفاء ورحمة للمؤمنين only. وَلَا يَزِيدُ الظَّالِمِينَ إِلَّا خَسَارًا Doesn't help the wrongdoers, the oppressors, the non-Muslims. Doesn't help them, but helps Muslims. That's why when we said, someone said, Quran doesn't help me, doesn't help. Said, oh, listen, it's your problem, it's your fault, not the Quran. It's your fault. You remember the man who came to the Prophet and said, Ya Rasulullah, my brothers have a tummy ache. He said, اسقه عسلا. Give him honey. Okay, I give him honey. Still, he has a tummy ache. Give him honey. The third time, give him honey. Then Ya Rasulullah, still the tummy ache. He said, Sadaqallah wa kadabat batnu akhik. Allah said the truth. And your brother's tummy is a liar. Allah said, honey is shifa. If your brother hasn't been cured, he has a problem. Yeah, it's not the honey. Honey is a cureness. Same. Quran for Muslims is a cureness. If you have a problem, I wish if you give me 2 minutes for this quickly, but although we need to cover it in details. No doubt, majority of people on the world, they have stress. Everyone, ask anyone, he will say, I'm stressed. I have stress. Depressed, he's not really happy. He can't find the rest. Everyone complaining now. But the problem is, this is two types. Someone stressed because of dunya.
Do you think this stress is haram to say, I have stress, I'm stressful? Yes, there is two types. One is, it's not good, haram. And the other one is recommended. Has anyone of the true mu'min has the stress? Yes. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa
sallam.
He used to get panic. But for dunya, no. For business, people getting panic because of their business. I don't know, getting panic because of their risk, because of the illness. Someone is panicking. Why? I don't want to get cancer. I don't want to get this virus. He is almost stressful. Why? Because he doesn't want to lose dunya. He doesn't want to lose business. He doesn't want to get ill. He doesn't want to. This is the people, majority of people. You know the credit crunch when it happened? How many people died? How many people went to the hospital? The mental disease because of what? Because of dunya. But the Prophet ﷺ, has he got any panicking before? Yes. When it is cloudy like this, windy, he used to get scared, fear. When it is rained, feel the brightness of the face of the Prophet ﷺ. Aisha, she used to see this. Ya Rasulullah, I can see this in your face. Said, Ya Aisha, when I see the cloudy, the wind, I remember the verse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَلَمَّا رَوْهُ عَارِضًا مُسْتَقْبِلَ أَوْدَيْتِهِمْ قَالُوا هَذَا عَارِضٌ مُمْطِرُنَ بل هو ما استعجلتم به ريح فيها عذاب أليم. For عاد, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the wind to destroy them, they thought, oh, this is cloudy, it's going to rain very soon. It is not. It's going to destroy you. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to get scared, fear. When it's rained, Allahu Akbar, alhamdulillah. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that, لَوْ تَعْلَمُونَ مَا أَعْلَمْ. If you know what I know, لَدْحَكْتُمْ خَلِيلًا. You will laugh a little bit. وَلَبَكَيْتُمْ كَثِرًا. You will cry all your life. And you will never feel the rejoice with your wife at home. You will never feel the rejoice with the dunya. You will come out from your house. تَجْأَرُونَ إِلَى اللَّهِ. Ya Allah, Ya Allah, help Ya Allah, mercy, your forgiveness. If you know what the Prophet ﷺ knew. Panicking happened to Abu Bakr al-Siddiq when he asked Hanzala, how are you Hanzala today? He said, leave me, I'm munafiq. He can't really, stressful Hanzala, why? I can see my iman when I be with the Prophet ﷺ. Big difference between me and when I go back to my business, my children. Abu Bakr said, I'm feeling the same. So they get panicked, but before the hereafter, Abdullah ibn Umar, when he used to come to the Salah, they can see his face getting really. Why, Ya Umar, Abdullah, every time we get you wudu to get ready for Salah, I can feel your face getting changed. He said, don't you know who I'm going to meet now? Don't you know who I'm going to stand before? I'm going to stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. People, when they go to interview, you see how they will be panicking for the interview. Now you are standing, talking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes. What's the shifa? Is the Quran. وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ. If you don't feel this when you recite the Quran, don't say, the fault is you. The fault is yours. The fault is your heart. The fault is you hear the Quran with your ears. You should hear the Quran with your hearts. أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ أَمْ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبٍ أَقْفَالُهَا. Don't they understand the Quran? Reflect the Quran. Or their hearts is really locked. It's not really open for the Quran. Why the Prophet ﷺ, when he described Khawarij, the Khawarij, he said, when you look at their Salah, you will say, oh, I am not a Muslim, my Salah is rubbish. Sorry about this word. Yeah? This, my Salah is not really good. Why? Because they pray in a such way, amazing. When you look how they recite Quran, they recite Quran in a beautiful way, all the time reciting Quran. But he said, لَا تُجَاوَزْ حَنَاجِرَهُ أَوْ تَرَقِينَ. When they recite with their throat only, doesn't go to the heart. So this is useless.
Quran will not benefit you unless you hear it with your heart. That's why we say, Allahumma ja'al Quran al-azima rabi'a qulubina. We want this Quran to be like the rain, come to the hearts. It was the dry, hard. When the Quran comes, it will become soft, alive again. As Rabi'a, when Rabi'a come to the, the earth, when the rains come to the earth, you know, you can see now the flowers, the green. Why? Because the rains come now. We want Quran to be like this for our hearts. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس. هدى للناس. This Quran is a guidance for all human beings, all mankind. Quran هدى للناس. So even those non-Muslims, if they want to get guidance for their life, they will find it in the Quran. هدى للناس. And the guidance here is هدايت بيان. You remember all the time we remember Hidayat Bayan and Hidayat Tawfiq. Al Hidayah, Hidayatan. The guidance is two types: Hidayat Bayan and Hidayat Tawfiq. Hidayat al Bayan, to clarify the signs, the reasons. Ayat, this is the Quran. Hidayat Bayan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the Quran to guide us, to clarify, to show you the truth. Allah sent the prophets to show us the truth, this Hidayat Bayan, to guide us, to clarify, to answer whatever any question we will ask, this Hidayat Bayan, to tell us the truth. There is Hidayat Tawfiq, whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will for him to be guided, he is the one who will be guided. مَنْ يَهْدِي النَّمْ فَهُوَ الْمُهْتَدْ. Whoever Allah guides, he is the one who will be guided. Many people, they read the Quran, many people, they make the Prophet ﷺ, but there is no tawfiq from Allah to be guided. Here, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس. It is a guidance for mankind. وبينات من الهدى والفرقان. بينات, you'll find حلال الحرام in Quran. You'll find حق الباطل in Quran. The truth and the falsehood in you can find. Al-Furqan, Furqan, which clarifying, differentiate between the haqq and batin. It is the Quran. The time is up and I'm going to stop. We will inshallah continue. I don't want people just to get tired. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq and give us life to be there in Ramadan.
Ameen.
And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the perfect way in Sha'ban and Ramadan.
Ameen.
And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to prepare ourselves for Ramadan.
Ameen.
This is again and again reminder. If you prepare yourself sincerely for Ramadan, even if you die before Ramadan, you will be rewarded for Ramadan.
Ameen.
And it's not from me, it is from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa
sallam.
Whoever done something, prepared himself to do something and something stopped him, that's why when you go to Umrah or Hajj, you say, Allahumma mahalli haythu habastani, oh Allah, I'm now get ready, Ihram is ready, I'm going to do Hajj or Umrah, but if something stopped me to do Umrah or Hajj, or perform the Umrah or Hajj, I will be now, I'll take off the Ihram. And this is what, subhanAllah, Umrah al-Hudaybiyah, still Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted as Umrah. Sahaba and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came up to Mecca, at the border of Mecca, and the kuffar stopped them to go to do Umrah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he took off his ihram and slaughtered the hadi, and it is called Umrah. And it was counted as Umrah, because Sahaba, they were rewarded as if they performed the Umrah. The man who was in Ihram and going for Hajj, just before Mecca, he fell from the camel and died. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, and he wash him and wrap him in his Ihram. Don't cover his head, because he will come on the day of judgment, resurrected, saying, Labbaik Allahumma Labbaik. So anyone preparing himself sincerely now for Ramadan, he would be rewarded, inshaAllah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala قال اول فاس وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى اله وصحبه وسلم. جزاكم الله خير.
جزاك الله خير. الله.